Assalamu alaikum and hello everybody inshallah. We are together inshallah in another program that we will talk about scientific refutation of Darwinism, deception of evolution, and we will talk about end times and the Mahdi inshallah. And we have some faith related topics, and we have science leading to faith. We are together here with my brother Mehmet Atmaca.
Good evening everybody.
Inshallah. So we can start with protein molecules. As you know, proteins are the basic building blocks of all the living beings, because the living cells are made of proteins. There are structural proteins, there are enzymes, there are hormones, and the proteins make our muscles, for example. The basic proteins of hair, keratin, and there are collagen in the skins and the bones. So basically, protein molecules, without protein molecules, life is, from that meaning on, not possible by Allah's leaves, inshallah. Proteins have a very specific structure. They are giant molecules that are, they consist of amino acid molecules. So there are some proteins which consist of a couple of thousand protein amino acids, and there are proteins which consist of like 50 amino acids, very small ones. So even the absence of a single amino acid, the protein structure, the protein becomes dysfunctional. Or if you change the place of one amino acid, it makes proteins dysfunctional also. They have a very specific sequence, and that is encoded in the DNA molecule. So the genes of the DNA molecule, which make like 2 to 3% of the DNA, the genes are the places of the DNA on the DNA molecule. DNA in human DNA is like 1 to 1.5 meters long. There are specific areas of the DNA which are called genes. The end product of genes are either protein molecules, polypeptides, or RNA molecules. However, these genes, and it is estimated that human DNA has about 25,000 genes, the genes in the human DNA make like 2 to 3% of the DNA molecule. So the functions of the rest, 97 to 98% of the DNA, is not known exactly. But it has a certain function, but it is not known exactly. But the genes are areas where the protein molecules are encoded. So, but proteins have a very specific sequence. And I remember I told you that if the amino acids places are being changed or is missing or added new amino acids, it makes the proteins dysfunctional. So this could be also applied to the genes, because genes must have a very specific sequence since they encode the protein molecules. For an average sized protein molecule, 500 amino acids, the number of the alternatives of this amino acid sequence is, since for each step, each spot, amino acid spot, since there are 20 different amino acids, left-handed 20 different amino acids, the alternative number mathematically is, this is 20 to the power of 500. Because since there are 20 different alternatives, 20 to the power of 500 alternatives for protein molecule with different sequences of amino acids. And that makes 10 to the power 650. 10 to the power 600, out of these 10 to the power 650 different alternatives for this protein molecule with different amino acid sequences, only one of them is functional. The rest is dysfunctional. So practically, even though there would be an intelligence involved, which makes these alternatives in the laboratory, for example, the scientists, by using computers, by an error and trial mechanism, they will be looking for a protein molecule with 500 amino acids, and they will put these amino acids one by one together, and it will stop at the 500 amino acid, will not allow any more amino acids to be involved in this chain, or even less involved in this chain. They would stop even the 500 amino acid, And if this is not the protein they are looking for, disentangle them and start over all again. And every time we try a different combination, memorize the combination they have done in the past, and memorize that, and we'll do a different combination. The time of the universe is not enough to make such reactions. These number of the reactions, 10 to the power of 650 different alternatives, exceeds the time of the universe. That number exceeds the time of the universe.
Just a single protein come to being, a life of a universe is not enough.
The time, the time of the universe, starting from the very beginning, Big Bang, is 10 over 17 seconds.
Yeah.
The maximum number of the reactions in the fastest way and happening one by one without any pause since the beginning of the universe would be only estimated to be 10 to the power of 220 reactions. So 10 to the power of 650 different alternatives. Far exceeds the time of the universe. The number of the atoms in the entire universe is 10 to the power of 78. The number of the atoms far exceeds the number of this, the number of these molecules far exceeds the number of the atoms in the entire universe. The number of the atoms in the entire universe is not enough to make the, such a reaction to these reactions in the laboratory. And also, remember I told you, if this happens, only if intelligence is involved. However, in the nature there is no intelligence, so there is no error and trial mechanism in the nature. These reactions will not even start in the nature if you leave the amino acids in the nature together. They will not form proteins, they will not form polypeptide chains, because if you leave amino acids in the nature, they get destroyed immediately because of the ultraviolet, oxygen and the metal ions in the soil. Or if you leave them in the water, that destroys the amino acids also. So in the nature they get destroyed, they never build protein molecules. For since they have to build through a very specific chemical bond called peptide bonds, and these peptide bonds require enzymes to be built, and only the living cells have these enzymes, amino acids never build peptide bonds in the nature also. And also only the left-handed ones are selected in the living cells for some unknown reason. And if a right-hand one amino acid is involved in the protein chain, it makes it dysfunctional also. So there is an intelligence which is involved and only selects the left-handed ones. And that is infinite wisdom of Allah, reflection infinite wisdom of Allah. Mm-hmm. Anyway, to summarize, again, the conditions I mean can only operate in a controlled environment. The problems that I have mentioned can only operate in a controlled environment. These numbers are not valid to the nature. In the nature, a single protein to emerge by coincidences is 0%, impossible. It is just impossible, it never happens. Mm. Scientifically we know that, logically we know that. So that of course destroys Darwinism at the very beginning. Yeah. And after that, there is no reason to take some fossils and engage into speculation or engage into a debate, whether this evolved from that or that evolved, this or this is the ancestor of that, because there is no such thing. No. Darwinism dies at the very beginning. Now I have a short film about the protein molecules that I would like to show you, so we can watch that together. Proteins are extremely complex molecules created by Allah, and a protein molecule to be produced requires a complete cell to be produced.
Proteins are large molecules made up of amino acids that serve many vital functions in living organisms. Proteins consist of chains of amino acids linked together by peptide bonds. The order in which the amino acids are strung together determines the type of protein, and there are many types. Enzymes trigger chemical reactions between cells. Hemoglobin, a red blood cell protein, helps with the transport of oxygen. Antibodies fight off invading substances, such as viruses. Collagen and keratin are structural proteins found in bones, tendons, skin, and hair. In humans, hormones are protein messengers that regulate metabolism, growth and maturation, reproduction.
Well, as we have seen, proteins, there are protein molecules with very different functions, and they all have a very specific design and function. That means, of course, they are being created by Allah, and the existence of the proteins require a living cell, and the cell's complexity is beyond imagination. A living cell is, which is about 1/100th of a millimeter in size, is like a large metropolis such as New York, London, which is even more complex than the largest metropolis of the world, because it has data bank, it has high-tech factories, refineries, security systems, highways, pipelines, and a seemingly conscious membrane which controls everything which goes into the cell and out of the cell. So a cell with all of its complexity is an evidence of infinite wisdom of Allah and creation of Allah, mashallah.
Mashallah.
Yes. And so we also, Big Bang is an evidence of creation of Allah, which is a proven fact, scientifically proven fact, and destroyed the claims of materialism, the materialist philosophy. Materialism absolutely rejects the existence of anything beyond matter. It only accepts matter as absolute, and they claim that matter existed since infinite, since forever, and will exist for forever. That was the claim of the materialism, which goes back and back to the ancient Greece, and even further back. It is a pagan religion, materialism. Darwinism and materialism are both pagan religions, complementary actually, of course, which denies the existence of a creator. But however, Big Bang had destroyed all their claims. You may want to talk about, tell us about Big Bang.
You are absolutely right. Even in the 19th century and beginning of the 20th century, still some scientists were claiming that universe were stable. And after the proofs of Big Bang come to the being, scientists realized that there was a beginning of the universe. Even one of the biggest scientists were thinking that the universe was stable.
Einstein, for example.
For example, the Einstein. He made the calculation of the universe size and so on, but he found out that there was some mistake of his calculations. After all, because of this was a main aspect of all the scientists, he didn't continue his calculations. He thought that he made a mistake. But actually, after...
Yeah, he added a constant into his calculations.
Yes.
To make fitted into the materialist model of that time.
Exactly. After the proofs of Big Bang were so clear and proved, should I say, he said, that was the biggest mistake of his career, that he couldn't continue and find out that the universe was not stable. So, to focus on Big Bang is actually will clear people's mind and understand that this is actually a fact of a creation and clear wisdom of Allah. For example, it's quite hard for us to upset, for example, equilibrium between the elements that are essential to life of Earth. You do not suddenly, for example, start breathing carbon monoxide, for example, or just you don't float away because of the decrease of the gravity, for example, or sunlight does not suddenly damage your eyes or skins, or oxygen leaves do not rise to high that your lungs get burned. Of course, there are many reasons of this. However, the interesting thing is that the balances assume their present forms due to Big Bang, defined as the explosion of a single point of zero volume that contained all matter in the universe. This sentence is very important, actually. We are talking of a single point of zero where all the matter of universe is inside. This is actually something one should really think of. So, of course, after countless conditions combined in order to maintain such equilibrium. For example, if the rate of universe's post-Big Bang expansion had been just one in a billion, that means one in ten out of power of 18 different, the universe would have not emerged. So this is very tiny difference that what should have been. But even such a single difference might have happened, then our universe would never have emerged. If the universe had expanded just slightly more slowly, if we think about the speed of the universe, if it just slightly more slow, then our universe would have imploded due to the fact of gravity force. So, if it had expanded little more quickly than we think the other way around, if the expansion was little bit more quickly, then all cosmic matter would have disappeared and vanished. So, when we take a look around us, everything is an extraordinary state of status, calm and perfection. And because nothing in the universe can come out of coincidence. In fact, everything depends on a flawless and perfect level of extraordinarily delicate balances created and set into the motion by Almighty Allah. Allah, who rules everything, created a flawless artistry and miracle via single explosion and is all-giving. He who created the seven heavens in layers, you will not find any law in the creation of all the all-merciful. Look again. Do you see any gaps? Then look again and again. Your sight will return to you dazzled and exhausted. Surah Al-Mulk 3 and 4.
MashaAllah. So Allah says, you will not find any flaw in the creation of all the merciful. I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. You will not find any flaw in the creation of all merciful.
No.
And yes, as you stated, the balances are so delicate. And in, as you stated, it is beyond imagination. If it would be 1 in 1 billion billion, which is 1 in 10 to the power of 18, this is a number with 18 zeros.
Yeah.
1 in 10 to the power of 18 means 18 zeros next to number 1. The slightest difference makes it impossible for the universe, for the atoms to come into being. The atoms, the matter would not come into being. The galaxies, our Earth would not come into being. So of course, only that fact shows us that entire universe and matter and everything is created by Allah.
Yes.
We don't need anything else. No. This fact destroys all the claims of materialism, Darwinism, anything. It shows there is a almighty creator with infinite wisdom, power and artistry.
Yeah.
Because such a delicate balance can only be controlled with of an almighty Allah with infinite power, inshallah.
Inshallah.
And Allah keeps creating every moment. Every moment, and this is a fact we know from the Quran, and every moment there is creation by Allah, inshallah. Allah inshallah creates on and on, inshallah, mashallah. And Allah controls everything, not only this delicate balance in the Big Bang, the oxygen pressure in the atmosphere, for example, the amount of the rains which fall down to the earth, and the amount of water which vaporizes every year are in delicate balance. They are exactly the same, which is a scientific miracle of the Quran. And the living cells, and that in the living cells, in human cells, for example, every second, 2,000 new proteins are being produced, and they are distributed wherever they are needed. And there is, if I summarize, an infinite wisdom of Allah controls everything, inshallah.
Inshallah.
MashaAllah. And so we will go on some other scientific evidences, and I would like to talk about the brain, inshallah, which is also a miracle of the creation by Allah. And human beings, the human brain consists of about 100 billion nerve cells, and we have the estimated number of the connection between these cells, these 100 billion cells, is more than 100 trillion, it is estimated.
Amazing.
So this
numbers.
Is a number, and you know, the volume of the brain is about that much, 1,400 grams. In a volume like this, the number of the connections, which are microscopic, only with the special electron microscope they can be visualized, the number of the connections is 100 trillion, more than 100 trillion, without any mistakes. Without any mistakes. So, and this is built, of course, during the embryo state of human beings, the connections are made in a very controlled way by Allah, of course. That shows us the structure of the human brain, that there is no room for randomness or coincidences, as evolution claims. In fact, it is created by Allah. It is a very powerful evidence. Now, I will show you some pictures, inshallah, taken with the electron microscope and microscopes. These cells you see over here are cerebellar Purkinje neurons. These are very specific cells. Our cerebellum is mostly concerned with the equilibrium and for the fine-tuning of the motor movements, that movements that we do. It is has a duty of control, finely tuning these movements that we do, inshallah, motor movements. This photomicrograph shows a portion of the cerebellum in which only one type of neuron, it is Purkinje cells, has been eliminated by a genetically encoded fluorescent protein. Meanwhile, other classes of neighboring neurons that would have clouded the view have been left invisible. So you see a very fine structure, which can only be visualized with the microscopes, but there is an incredible organization and order in this structure. So there are no mistakes. The cells are in the right place, and the connections are exactly as they should be. This is a spinal neuron that you see over here. This picture is taken with the electron microscope. Electron microscopy grants researchers and clinicians access to the universe that is too small to be detected, and we see the pictures. This photomicrograph was obtained by a scanning beam of electrons across the sample, while a detector kept track the electrons bouncing off its surface, betraying the specimen's outer shape. It shows a soma with dendrites radiating from it. You see a nerve cell over here, and the dendrites radiating from it. This is a nerve cell. And this is a chick retina. You see the order of the neurons. At the top of the image are the retina's photoreceptor cells, which are in gray. The familiar rods and cones that capture photons of light and translate them into electric signals that the brain can understand. So again, there is an incredible order and organization, which is also a miracle of creation. Inshallah, shows Allah's artistry. That is a single neuron picture you see over here, the pink one, and the red ones around this pink single neuron, then you see pink neurons. These are the neurons which make a connection with the single neuron. And so Francis Crick, who turned his attention to neuroscience after his seminal work on the structure of DNA, once wrote that a critical tool the field was still lacking was a technique for injecting a single neuron in such a way that all the neurons connected to it and only those are labeled. Recently, a group of scientists have transformed the rabies virus into a tool to accomplish just this by harnessing the virus lethally efficient natural mechanisms and turning it around to address Crick's challenge. Here this single neuron is in red and the ones connected to it are in yellow, you see. It is against also the evidence of creation by Allah. And this image shows a single neuron soma and dendrites at center orange. The one in the center, you see, is the orange one, is single neuron soma. And these yellow ones are dense branches of its axon, yellow ones. The latter spreads throughout a considerable portion of the rodent's hippocampus. Hippocampus is an area implicated in learning and memory and shuttles this neuron's information to thousands of others. The blue background reflects a staining of many neighboring neurons, revealing the overall structure of this brain region. Again, this is another picture taken from the cerebellum. The brain's neurons are small, convoluted, and very densely packed, you see over here. These are nerve cells, neurons, and packed in an area. But again, there is no disorder. There is an incredible order in this organization. So every neuron knows its duty and never mixes up. So the connections are just in the right positions, and billions of them, as I told you, there are more than 100 trillion connections in the brain, estimated, even more than that. Again, another spinal neuron that you see over here, these swellings that part of them called presynaptic boutons. These are the presynaptic boutons which make the connections between two neurons, these buds that you see over here, swellings. And this is from the cortex, the cortical layer of the brains, and the outer layer of the brain to reveal horizontal layers. You see again nerve cells, and this is of course taken with the microscopes and shows us what kind of perfect design, of course, by meaning design, Allah does not to design. Allah just says be and it is, inshallah, Allah says in the Quran. So the structure shows us as a powerful evidence the omnipotence of Allah, mashallah. Again, this is from human visual cortex taken with the functional MRI, and this is the area, this is the vision center of human brain, and this area is the area which controls takes the vision from the central part of the retina, and this is a peripheral layer, and this is the most peripheral layer that you see over here from the retina, from the eye. So these pictures of course shows us and perfect creation. There is no flaws as indicated in the verse that you just read, and Allah says there are no flaws in the creation. And these connections of the nerve cells, which are microscopically small and which make 100 billion neurons, nerve cells make 100 trillion, more than 100 trillion connections, means a creation beyond imagination, without any mistakes. So there is no chance in that. It is an evidence of creation of Allah, mashallah. Now, we have, of course, Darwinism is a fallacy based on no evidence whatsoever. It's a pagan religion. It's a false religion. It's just a superstitious religion from the time of the Sumerians and Pharaoh of the Egypt, which is founded upon chance. And the claim of Darwin was that life emerged by coincidences, and then coincidences produced these all the millions of living species. It is like Darwinism basically worships chance as a creator, unconscious atoms as a creator. And also, since this is a lie, every time they try to support it, they generate new lies and come up with the forgeries and frauds. Now I would like to show these about the false proofs of evolution, the fictitious human family tree. I would like to show a film about that, and we can talk after that.
Evolutionists based their thesis of so-called human evolution, their major claim, on fictitious and imaginary family tree diagrams. They do not have the slightest evidence to support their claim that human beings evolved. For that reason, they manufacture their own evidence by completing the various skull and bone fragments they collect during excavations with hoax illustrations in whatever manner they so choose. They give these imaginary pictures various names and create a supposed family tree of human evolution by setting them out in a sequence of their own choosing. The Nebraska Man hoax, which you saw earlier in this film, is one of the most notable examples of these imaginary representations. Evolutionists produce images of a fictitious human ancestor on the basis of a single tooth that they would later prove to belong to a boar. They went even further and added representations of his wife and children. The imaginary species to which they give the name Nebraska Man was for years portrayed as scientific evidence in evolutionary literature. Naturally, evolutionists' efforts to produce false evidence did not come to an end with the Nebraska Man. Proponents of evolution have produced countless false intermediate forms for their imaginary family tree on the basis of various fragments of bone they have discovered. What encourages evolutionists to produce such false evidence is the large numbers of fossils on which they can base their groundless speculation. More than 6,000 species of ape are known to have lived over the course of history. A large part of these have become extinct and disappeared. Today, there are only 120 species of apes in the world. Therefore, the fossil remains of around 6,000 extinct species of ape represent a rich resource for evolutionists. Evolutionists put together skulls and bone fragments from some of these extinct species according to their requirements. They then arrange these in order of size, from small to large, and write scenarios of human evolution by adding skulls belonging to some extinct human races to this series. This scenario contains a great many imaginary species that never actually existed at all. The false nature of all these imaginary species claimed to represent the forerunners of human beings, such as Java Man, Beijing Man, and Lucy, have all been demonstrated over and over again. And evolutionists have countless times admitted that the fossils they have submitted as evidence are a very far cry from being in the slightest bit scientific. A great many fake fossils have been proposed as so-called forerunners of human beings, including Java Man, discovered on the island of Java by the Dutch anatomist Eugene Dubois and claimed on the basis of a skull, which later transpired to belong to a gibbon, to be a so-called ancestor of human beings. Beijing Man was heralded as a forerunner of human beings on the basis of independent bone fragments found at different times over the course of a 10-year period in the area around Beijing. These fragments then mysteriously disappeared, leaving behind nothing more than fantastical pictures and models. Then, there was the Pithecanthropus fossil, discovered in India in 1932, and alleged to represent the first stage in the supposed transition from ape to man. This was used as definitive evidence by evolutionists for 50 years, until it was realized in 1982 that the fossil actually belonged to an ancient species of orangutan. The fossil known as Lucy was discovered by the American anthropologist Donald Johanson in 1974 and was regarded as a symbol of evolution for decades. Subsequently, even evolutionists abandoned it when it was realized that Lucy actually belonged to an extinct form of chimpanzee. Then there was the skull fragment found near the town of Ors in Spain in 1983, announced to be the oldest human fossil in Europe, and inserted into evolutionist literature under the name of Orsman. Later it emerged that the skull fragment actually belonged to a four-month-old monkey. These are just a few of the hoax fossils that evolutionists have come up with in order to provide supposed evidence for human evolution. In conclusion, all the paleontological, anatomical, and biological discoveries that have been made show that, like all other such claims, the claim of the evolution of man is completely invalid. The fossil record shows that throughout the course of history, human beings have always existed as human beings, and apes have always existed as apes. There is absolutely no concrete evidence of any familial link between human beings and apes. Apart from frauds, distortions, sleight of hand, misleading illustrations, and fictitious interpretations.
Well, it is so obvious that there is no evidence for evolution. In fact, all the evidence is refute evolution, shows us evolution never happened, and shows us that Allah did not create through evolution.
Yeah.
And the abrupt appearance of the fossils shows us that the species, all the living beings, were created all at once, fully formed by Allah, with His word be. That the fossil evidence tells us there are 350 million, more than 350 million fossils, which shows there are no transitions, expected imaginary transitional forms of evolution. And if you make, again, the description of transitional forms, and according to the Darwinism, according to the evolution, there should be half fish, half reptile, half bird, pathological and asymmetrical forms. Pathological and asymmetrical transitions, gradual transitions between species, but there is not even one of them. And these imaginary transitional forms should far outnumber the stable species. For example, if you have millions of species, the number of the transitional forms should be 100 billions and even trillions. But there is not even one, pathological asymmetrical transitional form. So that means species appear all at once, one by one, in the history of life, and they never change during their tenure on the earth until today, for example. We have living species, species of the living animals. They never change. And as we have seen over here, Allah created humans as humans and apes as apes. But evolutions always do is there are, since there are more than 6,000 ape species, and only 120 of them are alive, and the rest became extinct, they always take some fragments of either skulls of skeletons, or sometimes even the whole skeleton, of extinct ape species, and try to put it in order from smaller to larger one, and try to represent it as a so-called ancestor of man. Yeah. But this is a lie. It is a forgery.
Yeah.
This, we have always seen that in the Nebraska man case, in the Piltdown man, and also in the Ida and Arda recently. Ida is claimed to be an ancestor of man. It turned out with Harun Yahya actually. And, responded to that and stated that it is a lemur fossil. And so now after that, with the response, after the response of Mr. Harun Yahya, Mr. Adnan Oktar, New York Times apologized, BBC apologized. They said, sorry, it is not an ancestral man. It is just a lemur fossil. And then they tried to put forward this Ardi fossil, which was found in 1994 as a bonobo fossil. And Mr. Adnan Oktar responded to that again, stated that it's a bonobo fossil, and then after that, all the prominent paleoanthropologists, they apologized. They said, sorry, it is just an ape. It has nothing to do with the human beings. So, again, the fossil record and the scientific evidence tells us Allah created humans as humans, apes as apes. There are huge physiological differences. The way they walk, the structure of the heads, the structure of the jaw, the closeness of the eye, in the apes, and their arms are longer, legs are shorter, they walk stood forward, they have prominent eminences in the hands and the feet to attack, to hold the branches of the trees, and whole skeleton is created in a different way, and their balance organs, semicircular canals, inner ear is created in a different way also with different angles. Humans have larger skulls with 1,400-1,500 cc volume, and the shape of the face is completely different. Humans walk upright, the angle of the semicircular canal is different, the shape of the vertebra and angle of the vertebra to the pelvic bone is different, and the proportion of the arms and legs are different. Everything is completely different. But more importantly, humans are intelligent beings who can judge, who can build cities, civilizations, and take the electron microscope and do research on their bodies and generate paintings, for example, arts, science. Humans are created by Allah as conscious living beings with Allah breathed his soul to the human beings. Mm-hmm. And that is, of course, makes human beings very different from all the animals, inshallah. And so all the claims we have seen is wrong.
Oktar, cannot we say that from the movie that we just watched, all the fake proofs, that actually not a proof, but the facts that they are trying to announce people.
Allegations.
Allegations. Is that not the exact proof of a collapse of an evolution? If this was a scientific fact, they wouldn't need such a fake proofs, should they? Then they could just observe and make the research and put the exact fossils to the people, and then people would understand this is true or not. But they need such a fake fossils, they have to make some artificial drawings and so on, and this is enough evidence for thinking human being that evolution is just just has already been collapsed. Actually, as you have said, thanks to Harun Yahya, he come to the being and said, proved that, which they have never been expecting such a person to come out and shout out that these were not true. So they were, you know, claiming these things between each other. So no one was saying against anything. So they were very relaxed and creating such unacceptable evidences. But once Harun Yahya come and announced to everybody that this is not true, and after publishing this great book, more than 1,000 pages, so many pictures of unchanged fossils, proved and made people realize that all these have been faked. And as far as we know, no one has given any concrete answer to this book. Have you ever heard?
No.
So how can someone keep going and insisting of claiming that this is a science? Of course, people can still talk about it and believe in this religion of Darwinism. This is, one cannot say anything, but this is this should be known that this is a priority. People accept this as a religion and they can believe in it. But the realities, the science from the molecular base, from the beginning of the universe, like Big Bang, everything showed us in our short speech, that even shows us, gives us very enough evidences for us to believe in Allah.
Yes, you are, as you said, if Darwinists, they do forgeries, that means they don't have any evidence. If Allah would create through evolution, of course Allah could create through evolution, gradually,
as well,
the species,
yeah.
But this gradual evolution could only be creation of Allah. Only Allah can create through evolution. Allah can do through evolution, not by chance. Chance is so silly. Claim chance is so silly. So this chance nonsense is so silly. Allah could create through evolution, but if Allah would create through evolution, we would have the scientific evidences of that, fossils.
Yeah.
We would have all the gradual transition from species to other species in a perfect way. Symmetrical and creatures created with golden ratio by Allah, and they would be created gradually, the species. But Allah does not need any causes. That is, some people do not understand. Sometimes believers, Muslims, some Muslims, some Christians, Jews, they try to find a middle way with Darwinism and the religion. But this is because of they think Darwinism is the majority, even though it doesn't have
Darwinism
any evidence.
Darwinism is a science.
Yeah.
This is what they think.
They claim to be, they use the science as a cover. And these people think, we shouldn't be against science, we shouldn't be against the majority, and, you know, we should find a middle way. We can say, okay, Darwinism and evolution, God created through evolution, Allah created through evolution. No. We know that from scientific evidences, we know this from the Quran also. The fossil evidence, that is the only evidence which tells, which gives us information about the history of life. Only fossils, because since nobody was there at these times, 501 billion years ago, we only can know what happened in the history of life, how the species appeared, or were they in a transition between species, only from the fossil record. And if we check the fossil record, we have more than enough fossils. 350 million fossils tells us species appear abruptly, suddenly, and perfectly formed. All at once they appear, because with the word of be of Allah. Allah is beyond any causes. Allah says in the Quran, Allah says something to just be, and there it is, Allah says. And Allah creates. So we also know from the Quran, not only from the science, of course, other scientific evidences from genetics, molecular biology, microbiology, all tells us that there is no development from primitive to complex as Darwinism claims. And this, even the single cell, the first cell appears all at once and fully formed. And otherwise, it is logically and scientifically impossible. The cell cannot function if any of its organelles is missing. So there cannot be a development of a cell, even a single cell, from primitive to complex. For example, an organelle by itself. The cell consists of many organelles. It has many organelles, such as mitochondria, for example, the power stations. Mitochondria by itself does not mean anything. If you leave mitochondria in the nature, it gets destroyed immediately. It is not a cell. So with this Darwinist logic, it is not illogic, of course, it is illogic, it is so silly. If they say, for example, if one of the organelles of the cell is formed by coincidences and would wait for millions of years for a second organelle to come and add to it, I mean, this is so silly. Any organelle doesn't mean anything. It is just dysfunctional. It does not function. It gets destroyed in the nature immediately. Of course, we talked about the proteins. Even the proteins cannot emerge by coincidences, but organelle cell cannot emerge by coincidences. Cells cannot emerge by coincidences. The living species, living beings with all these complexities cannot emerge by coincidences. The universe cannot emerge by coincidences. In fact, all the scientific evidence shows us universe is created, living beings are created, the single cells are created, proteins are created. So, and again, this is a pagan religion. That is the reason why they defend it against all these scientific evidences. Of course, Darwin knew there was no evidence of evolution. Of course, Richard Dawkins knew there is no evidence of evolution. And in fact, Richard Dawkins say, Darwinism made it possible to be an intellectually fulfilled atheist, he says. And that is the reason why he defends this Darwinism nonsense against all the scientific evidences. He knows there is no evolution. And also we know from the Quran that there is no evolution. And I was talking about that these sometimes Muslims and Christians and Jews try to find a middle way with the religion and Darwinism, between Darwinism and religion. However, that is wrong. Majority doesn't mean anything. Darwinism has no scientific evidences. And in fact, in the Quran, we see evidences of sudden creation by Allah. For example, Moses, peace be upon him, throws his staff on the ground. That is stated in Allah by Allah in the Quran. He throws his staff into the ground. It suddenly, all of a sudden, transforms into a snake. A staff, which is made of wood, by unconscious atoms, transformed an inanimate matter. Of course, it is an inanimate matter made of inanimate matter. It transforms into a living being. All of a sudden, no evolution. Is there an evolution? No, there is no evolution. And there are jinns and there are angels created in the, we know from the Quran. Allah says, inshallah. Are they created through evolution? Of course not. They are created with the word be of Allah. And also, Jesus, peace be upon him, Isa, peace be upon him, shapes the mud like a bird and breathes into that. That is also from the Quran. And it suddenly, all of a sudden, transforms into a living bird. Inanimate matter of mud transforms into a living bird. Is that an evolution? No. And also, in the paradise, there are Huris, Gulmans, and Vildans, inshallah. Are they created through evolution? Of course not. So, Quran tells us that creation is all of a sudden by Allah, inshallah, which is word be. Allah is beyond any causes. So, Allah is not bound with these causes that He is created. These causes are created for human beings. Again, as an example, for example, every human being requires parents, like a mother and father, because and a human being to be created, in the laws, according to the laws of Allah that Allah created, an ovum and a sperm cell is required. Sperm cell comes from the father and the ovum from the mother, right? So yeah. We need two cells. This is the rule that we observe in this world. Always, we know for somebody, a man and a woman is required, a husband and a wife, for a human being to emerge, inshallah, to be created. However, Allah can change this. In fact, Allah did. And an example of this is like Jesus was born without a father, and Adam, alayhi salam, peace be upon him, was created without any parents. Allah can change these laws, which are created for human beings, anytime He wants to. So, there is no middle way between a pagan religion and Allah's religion, inshallah, between Islam. So, it is exact whatever Allah tells us, and Allah tells us He created with His word be, all of a sudden, and scientific evidence of course supports it, because science is created by Allah, inshallah.
And I'm sure that people is realizing that this is not a science. Even the time of Darwin, he didn't say himself that if there are no transforming fossils found, then my claims would be collapsed. So he explained himself. At this time, he couldn't find. Now, till this age, they couldn't find. This is the reason they're trying to, show people that fake fossils. So, according to Darwin's explanations, his theory is already collapsed. So, all the books of Harun Yahya has already proved that this is not a science. Then now more and more people are realizing that this is something not be considered as science, and they can differentiate between science and Darwinism.
Yes, and now we have a message came from Germany from one of our brothers, Öztürk, inshallah. I would like to read you.
Okay.
Brother Öztürk said, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Wa alayna alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Brothers, first of all, I love you all, and we love you, Brother Öztürk, and the program is great. I would like to give you the information within in a short time. We are starting a program like yours in Germany, alhamdulillah, mashallah.
Mashallah.
And may Allah.
This just what we told? You know, people are realizing more and more everywhere in the world. This is one of the evidences, even in Germany, maybe everywhere in the world, people are starting such a programs.
Yeah, why?
And soon, inshallah.
Why just in Germany?
Yeah.
Everywhere we should have
This is
TV
just
programs.
One sample.
MashaAllah. Yeah. And MashaAllah, Adnan Oktar's books, which are more than 300 right now, are translated to more than 73 languages.
Yeah.
And in more than 200 countries of the world, They are being downloaded from the internet and they are being read by millions and millions of people, mashallah.
Mashallah.
More than 150 million people books were downloaded from the websites just in the last year, in 2010. More than 150 million books were downloaded, mashallah. Yeah. So this number is increasing and increasing.
Yeah. Well, actually, most of the people were not actually believing in Darwinism, but they were needing somebody who could they depend on. And this is what Harun Yahya did at the moment. He stood up only by himself against such a theory, and people were waiting for somebody like this to stand up against such a unbelievable theory. And after his steps, important steps, people have started to make programs and reading books and publishing similar books maybe. So he was like a leader of destroying an evolution.
Inshallah.
Inshallah.
Now, maybe we can, inshallah, talk about the science leading to faith, inshallah.
Yeah.
There are some birds called hummingbirds.
Yes.
Would you like to go ahead and, inshallah?
I mean, this is, again, one of the examples of millions, should I say. It's a bird called hummingbird. Which is the size of it, length of it changes from a little finger of an adult to the width of a regular sheet of paper. But what is the interesting point of this animal is that hummingbirds are big eaters. In the article of Dennis Dreeves, he says about the hummingbirds, hummingbird, the God's tiny miracle. He gives a human equivalent in the amount of food this little bird eat. The equivalent is 1,300 hamburgers a day with 60 liters of water.
Look, nobody can eat.
Yes, this much of a bird can eat 1,300 hamburgers.
Can you eat more than 10 hamburgers?
Yeah, I mean,
I can even not even more than 5.
Yeah, I mean, then the more you investigate why this bird eats so much food, scientists realize that these birds flies at a speed of 90 kilometers. I mean, as fast as a car. How could such a time, look at, think about my finger-sized bird, can fly as fast as one good car, produced in 20th century. And what's more interesting is, in a single second, this bird can beat its wings 50 to 80 times.
MashaAllah.
So think about the energy that this bird needs. So, of course, then he needs to eat that much hamburgers, of course, when you compare it. But think about, say we need to eat these hamburgers, then we have to also have digestion system according to it. You see so many obese people around, they eat a lot, but they cannot digest. Think about this, this bird should be as big as, maybe like a car or a big size, but still because of the energy it consumes and the wings that he has to beat 50 to 80 times with its digestion system and breathing system and everything, and complete evidence of wisdom. I mean, to make such an animal by coincidence or even with the help of engineering, it's impossible. So we cannot claim that this bird came out of just coincidence with such a features.
MashaAllah. And we see the pictures of hummingbirds over here that we can take a look. It is very beautiful with all the colors, and look at the symmetry and the golden ratio.
Yes, we don't even talk about the appearance of the bird, just two features of the bird. Yeah. Even these two features is enough for a thinking person to understand this is a fact of a creation.
MashaAllah, yes.
MashaAllah.
And you see over here. And how many times did you say it can beat the wings?
50 to 80 in a second.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. And beautiful colors and beautiful symmetry.
Yeah.
And everything. And of course, for to beat the wings 50 to 80 times a second, it requires a respiratory system, bone structure, and all the organs, the heart and the vascular systems, all are designed to generate that much energy and to beat the wings for 50 to 80 times, the feather structure, everything accordingly, inshallah. And of course that means creation by Allah. Allah created its respiratory system, vascular system, cardiac system, the feathers and the structure, the aerodynamics, everything is created accordingly by Allah, mashallah.
MashaAllah.
And only this, only looking at this sign, it leads us to faith. Faith to Allah, inshallah.
Inshallah.
It's so easy and it's nothing complicated. Religion is not complicated, inshallah.
Inshallah.
And being irreligious is too much complicated, because anybody who divert from the way and become irreligious or denies the existence of a creator, then try to explain everything with hundred thousands of different lies, which are against the logic. For example, Darwinism, which is based on this chance nonsense, is like an attack to human logic. Everything is against the logic. They say these complexity of life emerged by coincidences. Then they say human is a product of a coincidences. It is an animal, and it has to fight to survive. And then of course this fighting and conflict concepts come into the life, into the societies, and it generates communism, violence, terrorism, fascism. It brings unhappiness, and of course everybody, Mr. Adnan Oktar said once, there is no true atheists. Everybody knows in subconscious mind that there must be a creator. Even the children know that. It is human logic is constructed this way, understands immediately there must be a creator of this. Everything we see, everything we smell and taste, these perceptions are created by Allah, and all these structures and complexities of the living beings are created by Allah. Of course, this entire universe is created by Allah. So fighting against this, why? Everything is beautiful with Allah. Allah's existence is so beautiful. If you imagine in a second, there is an omnipotent, almighty Allah with infinite wisdom, and Allah with infinite mercy and love to us. So death is not an end, and there is an infinite life, and there is paradise and pleasure of Allah, inshallah. Sure. Good pleasure of Allah. So everything is beautiful with Allah. And hasha, Allah is beyond this. Without Allah, there is chaos, there is nothing. I mean, death and disappearance and, that kind of things which destroys these people who become irreligious and deny the existence of the Creator. They get so unhappy, and they lose their health, they get older, they lose their mind, they get sick. In the opposite way, everything is so beautiful with the existence existence of Allah. Everybody becomes happy, a sincere believer becomes happy no matter what happens to him. He might get sick, he might be in the jail for struggling in the way of Allah. People may slander. Doesn't mean anything. You are happy because you're gaining good pleasure of Allah. That is beyond everything, inshallah.
Inshallah.
So everything is beautiful with the existence of Allah, mashallah. There is no reason to struggle against that. Yes, and also we can talk about the superior creation in the horse bones. This is another sign leading to faith. And there is a lot of pressure applied to the bones, stresses applied to leg bones of the horses, especially at a full gallop speed. One might assume that the immense pressure to which the leg bones are exposed could harm the bones, it could cause them to break. However, the structure of the bones is made in a perfect way by Allah, so that they do not break. And I will talk about this, the special structure which was discovered in recent years. The burden that is placed on the horse when it is gallop is largely borne by the third metacarpal bone in its leg. This bone is like about 25 centimeters long, with one side on its face consisting of holes. There are holes on one side of this bone through which the vessels emerge, blood vessels to run through. Normally in a given structure, if there are holes, of course it makes it weaker, logically, right? If you think, should make it weaker. When pressure is exerted on the rigid bodies, the first area for breakage or damage to occur is the point of a hole and its immediate surroundings. However, there is a very specific design of these holes in the horse bones, leg bones. And according to the, the holes make it weaker. This is according to the laws of the physics, all right? However, there is a special structure in the horse leg bones. Any pressure placed on the hole is absorbed and it dispersed throughout the bone. The special structure that guards the horse leg has also attracted the attention of some aircraft engineers, because the design, it was created by Allah, the way it was created by Allah. The metacarpal bone in horse is able to withstand any pressure, and it has been found in laboratory tests that within the radius of the hole, no visible signs of breakage were apparent, even though the actual bone displayed signs. The sign of breakage in the holes. The reason for this phenomena can be seen at the microscopic scale, with tissues encompassing the whole being organized in a special order, with the result that any pressure placed on the hole is absorbed and it dispersed throughout the bone. So they try to duplicate that, the aircraft engineers, because it is vital to strengthen and enhance the holes or hollow sections of the aircraft's main body with the aircraft's electrical cables. And Professor Dr. Andrew Rapoff has examined ways to solve this problem. His repeated attempts were never a success, as the plate through the hole never showed any signs of fracture. So, if anybody, just by seeing that with the 21st century's scientific science in the high-tech laboratories, not being able to duplicate the structure, which has been existing since tens of millions of years in the horses from the very beginning. And it's a miracle of engineering, actually. Of course, miracle of creation, not engineering, but of creation, because engineering belongs to man, humans. Of course, that is an evidence of creation by Allah.
And, so how can somebody claim that horse, bone of horse, can come out of a coincidence? Even a scientist trying to duplicate, they cannot manage, but somebody comes out and uses the name of science and claims that this bone has come to the being from by a coincidence. Thank you for explaining such a nice example.
And horses are beautiful living beings, very aesthetic and very cute, as we see over here, created by Allah, mashallah. And the horses are stated in the Quran also.
Yes.
So beautiful, very cute. Allah created so cute, with the golden ratio and perfect symmetry and perfect design. MashaAllah, you see?
MashaAllah.
So we will have a short break and we'll be back after that, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum again, and we will continue our program with faith-related topics and end times and Mehdi, appearance of the Mehdi. However, we would like to start with a film, short film, of Mr. Adnan Oktar's talk. Mr. Adnan Oktar's talk with Sheikh Nazım el-Kubrisi, which was done in 1987. So we'll watch this film, inshallah, together. I say, may Almighty God give you Who is he? Isn't he Adnan Hoca? I recognize him from his picture. Mr. Adnan Oktar says, thank you. I pray that he will bestow on you both that rank and also the authority. Almighty Allah bestowed seclusion for Salat upon our brother Adnan. In order to clothe him in the manifestation of the Prophet Joseph, peace be upon him. His completion of that is sufficient now. He has given him authority by dressing well. We hope that Adnan Bey will perform the most immaculate services in the future. Through the secret of being a guide, visible and also in other forms, through the secret of being a guide, there are services he will render and he has been rendering. We congratulate him, he has been written among the patients. One step ahead of the patients, he has also been written among those with whom Allah is pleased. His approval has also been given to him. I am thinking about this on myself. I look and see that it was not in the form that I could have borne. He, mashallah, was young at that time. He completed his service. At times, guides suffer such slanders, but it does not harm you. May Allah be pleased with you, Master. Astaghfirullah, those are all in the past. Now you have been clothed with a rank in the sight of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In this month of Muharram al-Sharif, you have been clothed with a spiritual soul and a spirituality that will separate you both externally and spiritually, and a perception, an inspiration with understanding has been bestowed on you. Upon that inspiration, do not concern yourself with things going on around, and then you will see the inspiration bestowed on your heart. Because as a result of the seclusion, as an entreat, the companion has been bound to your heart. Bound through inspiration, and you will bear no ill will saying that I have locked me up there. To those who have locked me, they have tried me. To those who have tried me, they have blamed me. To those who have blamed me, inshallah. Lower self would want to stay offended by those, but you are to reject that. And while you are on this way, there is now an obligation upon you. Without taking anyone beside you, you are to read the Holy Quran in that cell of yours by placing it on a high carriage, and as if you let it be a group, let it be two, let it be three, or a whole section if you like. After that, you will have a revenue, spiritual revenue will be imparted on you as a reward. And that is inspiration, and when that inspiration comes, you will not lose it. Once you have finished that reading, kneel down in the assembly, take pen and paper, and record what is born in your heart. That will be enhanced and broadened. It will be widened, not narrowed. It will increase. You will thus perform a great service, especially for those young people with a new perspective. A new understanding of the Holy Quran. Since this is a secret of being guide, I am charged with telling you this today. And you have sainthood. In other words, because you are saintly, you are one of the Evliya Allah, the friend of Allah. However, now it is like a rosebud. Neither its color, nor its shape, nor its scent are yet apparent. It will be apparent when it blooms. And Adnan Bey is like that now, that closed. Within a period of 24 hours, one time one Veli of Allah, one time another Veli of Allah, one time another Veli of Allah. Approval came from three saints and they have considered his heart. This was when he was either in prison or in hospital. And they had not considered like this. He would not be able to come out in that state. The travails of the Dangan could not have harmed him, but did not. They did not leave him to be harmed, and his fate and rank are now very different. From how he was before entering that chamber of seclusion. Yes, mashallah. This is Sheikh Nazım Kıbrısi's talk with Mr. Adnan Oktar from year 1987, right after Mr. Adnan Oktar was released from the mental hospital, psychiatric clinic. And he was blamed for one sentence that he said, "I am the nation of Turks, and I am nation of Turks, and I am a nation of Islam." For one sentence he said, and he was put into jail, locked up in the jail for about 9 months. And then after that he was put into a psychiatric clinic, a mental hospital, for more than 10 months. And at the end, the prosecutor said, there is no guilt on that. There is no crime on that. And he was acquitted from that trial. He was released. And after, in 1987, Sheikh Nazım Kıbrısi has made this talk about Mr. Adnan Oktar, and mashallah. Now, we also have another film of Mr. Adnan Oktar, and Mr. Adnan Oktar talking is on this film. Briefly, Turkey already has an Ottoman experience from before. Let's watch this film, inshallah.
Evet.
Yani üç kıtaya hakim olmuş. Evet. Ve şefkatli, efendi bir millet. Yani
they are compassionate, the Turks, for instance, when the army is moving ahead, they walk through a place abounding in vineyards. The Ottoman soldiers pluck and eat grapes. They take money out of their pockets, put it inside in a little sack. And hang it on the branches of the grapes they have eaten. I mean, they thus say, "We ate your grapes." There is no passing by and confiscating like gangsters. They are such an honest people, such a polite people. They fear Allah. Allah made them prevail because their system was constantly built on the fear of Allah. Europe would never have given Istanbul. Above all, it is their religious capital. How could they give religious capital up? But Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him, is going to emerge, so Allah makes them give it. That gave Istanbul because Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him, is going to emerge. That is, Allah made them give. About the Turkish Islamic Union, they have been, it is a great power. We do not have any economic power. We are a poor nation in that sense, right? We are a modest and a compassionate nation who is satisfied with a loaf of bread and some cheese. We do not live with very high quality cars and houses. The situation is, Anatolia is known. We have a big and rich heart. What Europe talking about is a spiritual system. We have an esteem. They have confidence in our compassion. They have confidence in our love. They have confidence in our respect. The Turkish soldiers go to Somali. They go to Afghanistan and they embrace them. We are a beloved nation. That is what is meant by Europe. We also want to be the leader. This is our destiny. Now look, to be more clear, the world state that rules the world wants in this way. I mean, they should not make me say any more, right? The world state calls for a Turkish Islamic Union in the leadership of Turkey. If you ask who is at the head of the state, it is obvious, inshallah. Look, the whole world is advancing towards this step by step. Obama comes out and makes a statement about this. The president of France comes out and talks about this. A power unknown to them drags, none of them could stop. Those who struggle against this are dragged along as well. So are those. For example, if you ask whether or not Fatih Altaylı calls for an Islamic Union, the answer is known. For example, what does he say about Erbakan? He talks in an inconceivable manner. This attitude would make up any man who is lazy in a state of sleep. He would say, "My sense of honor for Islam has burst. I came to my senses." He would thus realize the greatness of the incident, and this would bring enthusiasm. Yes. So, in this talk of Mr. Adnan Oktar, we have seen Turkey will be the natural leader of the Turkish Islamic Union, which will be an spiritual unity of not only of the Islamic countries, such as Turkey, Iraq, Iran, Syria, Egypt, Jordan, and other Islamic countries, Saudi Arabia and other Islamic countries, but it will also include such as Israel, for example, Armenia and Russia, and it will be a unity, Turkish Islamic Union, by the leadership of Turkey, a spiritual unity, inshallah, by Mehdi, inshallah, and Hazrat Mehdi, and it will bring peace, compassion, mercy, love, justice to the area, inshallah. It will eliminate all the wars and weapons, and in the hadith our Prophet stated that not even a drop of blood will be shed at the time of the Hazrat Mehdi, inshallah. And again, in this talk and in many other programs, Mr. Adnan Oktar explained that the leadership of Turkey is because of its historical and cultural comings, inshallah. So it is not a genetic leadership, not a genetic superiority or racial superiority, no such thing. But good morality of Turkey and history, which goes back to the time of the Ottoman Empire, which brought justice to the whole area, inshallah, makes Turkey a natural leader. And so with the leadership of Turkey, Turkish Islamic Union will bring, of course, leaded by, inshallah, Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him, will bring peace, compassion, mercy, love, justice, tolerance, and real democracy to the not only to the whole area but to the whole world, inshallah. Now, yes, and these times are very close by. We understand that from all the importance given by our Prophet has been happening. Now, I would like to, we would like to go ahead with a short movie about the Judgment Day, because living in the end times and all these portents stated by in the Hadith by our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all came to be true, more than 150 signs, shows us that we are close to the Judgment Day. Okay. And Allah wants us to pay attention, think about the Judgment Day, inshallah, and that we will give an account to Allah in the hereafter. So, I would like to show you a short film about that, inshallah. Before that day, Judgment Day comes, inshallah.
As time passes, the Judgment Day is rapidly approaching. The great majority of people think that it is generations long after their own that will be confronted by the Judgment Day. But a reminder needs to be issued here. Generations before our own thought along exactly the same lines and never even considered this event, which they imagined would take place in the far distant future. The fact is, however, that everyone who has ever lived since mankind was first created will witness the events that take place on the Judgment Day and will be called together in the presence of Allah. There will be no escape for anyone on that day. Moreover, there is no guarantee that this day will not occur as you go about your daily life and make plans for the future. The life created by Allah within such great order will come to an end, together with that order itself, at a time unknown to us. That last day will be a terrifying one of great distress for the deniers. For that reason, instead of not believing and waiting on events, it will be far more advantageous for people to believe in the Judgment Day and to have no doubt about its reality. It must not be forgotten that everyone will appear alone in the presence of Allah and be questioned on their own. That being the case, we need to make serious efforts and preparations for death and what follows. Because everyone will receive full recompense in the hereafter for their actions in this world, suffering not the slightest injustice. You who believe, fear Allah and let each self look to what it has sent forward for tomorrow. Fear Allah. Allah is aware of what you do. Do not be like those who forgot Allah, so He made them forget themselves. Such people are the deviators.
Yes, and so Well, the life is so transitory, and just we are very close by to death, and everybody will taste the death, inshallah. All of us, every human beings, and it is very close by, and it can happen any moment. So what we concentrate on is, we should concentrate on the hereafter, inshallah, to live accordingly, to gain the great pleasure of Allah. And that can only be possible if you follow and live according to the Quran, inshallah.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. So that's just a reminded us how should we spend our time, this short life, inshallah. And also, again, we are living in a very specific, special times of end times. And the return of Jesus is a fact which is stated in the Quran by Allah, inshallah. And also in the hadiths of our Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and in the Bible also. So, however, Jesus, Prophet Jesus, he will return in the end times, inshallah, Prophet Jesus, as a follower of Islam and the Sunnah of our Prophet. And one of the unrealistic claims made by certain people is that since Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was the last prophet, the Prophet Jesus will not be coming. That's what they say, that's what they claim. First, we should make clear that, as revealed in the verse 40 of the Surah Al-Ahzab, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah and the last prophet. He is the last prophet to whom the Quran was revealed. And the return to the earth of Prophet Jesus will not alter this fact. It will not change this fact. Contrary to what some people suggest, the Prophet Jesus will not come as a prophet who will be sent after the Prophet Muhammad, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but as a messenger who maintains the law of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and causes the moral values of the religion to rule the world. So Prophet Jesus will follow the Quran and the Sunnah of our Prophet, and he will be a follower of the Quran. And it is stated in the hadith by our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In one hadith, our Prophet stated, the Prophet Jesus will rule for 40 years with the Book of Allah, which means with the Quran, inshallah, and my Sunnah, and then die. This is what our Prophet said. It's from Suyuti, inshallah, Imam Suyuti. Jesus, the son of Mary, will descend as an imam, said our Prophet, and just ruler to the nation, religion, of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and will confirm him and will eliminate the Antichrist. So we understand he will be our follower, our Prophet, and follower of the Quran, inshallah. And also, our Prophet said he will accept no other religion than Islam. He will be a spiritual guide. No other being or entity than Allah will be worshipped. Jesus, peace be upon him, will not come to the people of Muhammad as a prophet, but to practice the religion of Muhammad. Jesus will descend and will practice our prophets, may God bless him and grant him peace law. So there are many hadiths about that, inshallah. There is no prophet between me and him, our prophet says. That is Jesus, peace be upon him. He will descend to the earth. When you see him, recognize him, a man of medium height, reddish hair, wearing two light yellow garments, looking as if drops were falling down from his head, though it will not be wet. He will fight the people for the cause of Islam. He will break the cross, annul the worship of the cross, kill the pig, inform that eating pork is forbidden, and abolish the jizya. Allah will cause to perish all religions except Islam. He will destroy the Antichrist, make him ineffective, and will live on earth for 40 years, and then he will die. The Muslims will pray over him. That is from Abu Dawud, Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawud, and Tirmizi, great hadith collection, mashallah. So we understand, Prophet Jesus will return as a messenger of Allah, and he will follow the Quran and the Sunnah of our Prophet in the end times, inshallah. And we also understand from all the signs given by our Prophet that he must have returned. Mr. Adnan Oktar said, he must have returned, he must be on action, inshallah, as Hazrat Mehdi must have appeared, because we see the sign of these. Not only 150 portents which are given by our Prophet, but also it is stated in the Hadiths and Bediüzzaman Said Nursi that the materialism and Darwinism, that will be the first duty of Mehdi alayhi salam, and he will eradicate these false religions, inshallah. And we see the signs of this, that materialism and Darwinism is going down, and Islam is in progress, religion is in progress, inshallah, spreading all over the world, mashallah. And these are the major signs that Mehdi must have appeared, and the golden age is very close by, inshallah. Mr. Adnan Oktar said, inshallah, Allah knows the truth, in most of 10 years, we will both see Hazrat Mehdi, alayhi salam, and Jesus, peace be upon him, and we will also see, inshallah, that Islam will prevail the whole world. Inshallah. From North Pole to the South Pole, from Asia to Africa, America to Europe, inshallah, all around the world, Islam will prevail, inshallah. And these times are close by. yes, and well, I would like to, we would like to actually talk about that, about those desiring the unity of Islam. There are some people who are desiring the unity of Islam without a leader. This is not possible, and I will explain why. Unity, that Muslims unite, is a command of Allah to all Muslims, and it's obligatory upon them. Bediüzzaman Said Nursi expressed this vital importance of unity for Muslims with the words, Bediüzzaman said, Said Nursi said, unity of Islam is the greatest obligation of this age. So the state of the Islamic world today, the things happening in Iraq, incidents occurring in Afghanistan, Iraq, Kashmir, East Turkestan, and other countries reveal how this union can cause detrimental results. And since Allah orders us to unite, to separate is haram, means forbidden, unlawful according to the Quran. So this is every day we spend with this separation, the Muslim world, is forbidden according to the Quran, inshallah. Because Allah says, I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. Hold fast to the rope of Allah and do not separate, Allah says. So separation is haram. Throughout history, Allah created every tribe with his leader, of course. So we know that, it's pioneer. This is a requisite of the law of Allah. In the periods of the Prophet Noah, Abraham, peace be upon him, Prophet Moses, Joseph, Jesus, and our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah's holy messengers led the Islamic communities as leaders of the believers. That is a requisite of the law of Allah, inshallah. And also, within destiny, Allah granted a beauty for the Islamic community. And following this period, without a spiritual leader, this is the today's situation, he gave the good news of a very blessed person of compassion and love with moral perfection, who is deeply concerned for Muslims and has a very strong sense of protection of Islam. And this person is Hazrat Mehdi alayhi salam, inshallah. Sure. And this style employed by those who say the Islamic world must unite but does not remember and mention the name of Hazrat Mehdi alayhi salam, or who try to cover the system of Mehdi, is simply insincere. Furthermore, such a style is against the Quran, Sunnah, wisdom, and rationale. So if there is a unity, there must be a leader of this unity, inshallah. Even, for example, according to these people find it very normal. They say it is normal for even the smallest group of people to have a leader, such as Catholics to have a Pope, for example, Orthodox Christians to have a Patriarch, Jews to have a leader, and even Freemasons to have a master. They regard it to be abnormal. There's a prime minister, for example, there is a president of the countries. They find this very normal. However, it comes to the Muslims, they say a leader is not needed, but this is very irrational, illogical. With such irrational, it is seen that they subconsciously desire for the Islamic world to remain in this union. That's what they carry in their subconscious mind. However, in the case of the existence of the unity of Islam, Hazrat Mehdi also absolutely exists. If Hazrat Mehdi exists, the Islamic world definitely unites. And this will definitely happen.
Inshallah.
We know that, we feel the signs, and we feel his footsteps. We smell the Hazrat Mehdi, inshallah. Because more than 150 signs, they are all happened, mashallah.
Inshallah.
They came to be true, given by our Prophet. And so, it shows us that the unity of Islam, inshallah, very close by with Hazrat Mehdi. Jesus must have returned, and with the existence of Jesus, inshallah, peace be upon him, and also Hazrat Mehdi's works, inshallah, the Christians and the Jews will also become Muslims, and Islam as the only religion will prevail in the whole world, inshallah.
Inshallah.
MashaAllah. And these days are very close by. And now we came to the end of another program, inshallah.
Sure.
And actually, yes, we have one more film that I would like to show you, inshallah, about the secret of the test in this world, inshallah. We can watch this short film, inshallah.
There is an important secret hidden in the atmosphere of trial that makes up this world. Those believers who are aware of it treat the difficulties they encounter with great eagerness, joy, and patience. At the heart of this secret lies the fact of fate. A Muslim knows that God has created everything with its own destiny, and that whatever happens to him does so by the will of God. This is how the Quran states that fact. The keys of the unseen are in his possession. No one knows them but him. He knows everything in the land and sea. No leaf falls without his knowing it. There is no seed in the darkness of the earth, and nothing moist or dry which is not in a clear book. Man is a being who can be regarded as living dependent on time and looking at events only from the present moment. Yet the future is closed to him. He is not always able to see the long-term wisdom, beauty, and benefits in the events he encounters. Yet God, who created time, sees and knows the lives of all time-dependent beings from outside time. What we are now dealing with is the fact of fate. Fate means God knowing every single event in the past and future in a single moment. In other words, events the end results of which are unknown, are only actually unknown to us. God is fully aware of all the things we are not, together with their pasts and futures. For this reason, the beginning and end of the test people are subjected to in this world are already clear. The past, present, and future are all one in the sight of God. They are all over and done with. We, however, only learn of these events by experiencing them when the time comes. This knowledge of fate is truly great knowledge, and something of which those who deny God are unaware. It is knowledge by means of which Muslims display great patience in the face of difficulties and tests in this world. They live in the peace and security of knowing that everything that happens to them is destined. As is revealed in the Quran, no misfortune occurs except by God's permission. Whoever believes in God, he will guide his heart. God has knowledge of all things.
Yes, inshallah. And so with this film, inshallah, we came to an end another program. Inshallah, we'll be together tomorrow at 2:30 a.m. Turkish time, GMT plus 2, with other topics of misconceptions of Darwinism, science leading to faith, and end times and other faith related topics, inshallah.
Inshallah.
Until then, salamu alaikum, shalom, and good night, everybody, inshallah.